Here is my slide deck that I'm going to check for accessibility. It's 17 slides, and it looks like it's intended to be used as part of an orientation session for new teaching assistants. As I said in the introduction, the modifications I'm going to make to this deck assume that this slide file will be distributed to the audience after the presentation is over, so I want to make sure that the digital file itself is accessible. That is, that it will be useful to audience members later on, whether they use a screen reader or not. The most important thing we can do to improve accessibility is to make sure the slide designer uses the predetermined layouts in the slide application rather than plain text boxes. What does that mean? All the major slideware applications, PowerPoint, Keynote, Google Slides, and Office Libre Impress, use layouts to form the basic structure of the slides. Here in PowerPoint, I can see the available layouts from the tool ribbon at the top of the application screen. I have options like title slide, title and content, section header, to content, comparison, plus a few others. I've got the first slide selected and I can tell what layout is in use with it because there's a highlight box around the title slide layout. I can change the layout that governs this slide by clicking one of the other boxes. See what happens when I click the layout called to content instead of title slide. PowerPoint rearranges my content a little bit. I'm going to undo that action because I want the title slide to use the title slide layout. I just wanted to show you the effect that layouts can instantly have on slide compositions. Let's look at another layout. I'll move to the second slide in this deck and again select the layout dropdown. I see that this slide is using the title and content layout. That's great, that's what we want. However, I also notice something a little odd about this slide, which is that this big black box extends all the way to the sides of the slide, which makes me think it might be a text box rather than part of the layout. I'm going to move it slightly to the slide, and yep, as I thought, it is a text box that is covering the layout placeholder. The layout placeholder for this slide says, click to add text, and that's how I know it's the placeholder, an integral part of the layout. Layouts are essentially templates that are comprised of content placeholders. We can view and even add or change the layouts in the Slide Master. To get into the Slide Master, I'm going to go to my View pull-down menu and select Master and Slide Master. And here is where we see a sort of behind-the-scenes view of this particular layout. Any changes I make here will be made to all the slides in this deck that use this layout. Now remember I said that layouts are comprised of content placeholders. The title area of this layout is a placeholder, this body content is a placeholder, and I could theoretically add additional placeholders to this slide if I wanted. I could resize the main content box, moving it off to the right, and use the Insert Placeholder button in the tool ribbon to add a new placeholder. See here that my options for content placeholders include a generic content box, a text-only content box, and a picture box, among others. But I don't want to mess with this slide right now because it suits our needs just fine. So I'll undo those two actions and just keep it the way it is. Now, content placeholders give the same appearance as text boxes, but they behave completely different. This is key. Putting content into these content placeholders means that an audience member who uses a screen reader will be able to read the content in them. Not so with the text boxes you manually create. I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to close this master using the Close Master button in the tool ribbon and come back to the slide itself. And remember, we determined that this black box was actually a text box. The text in this box won't be readable by a screen reader unless I take the additional step of adding alternative text to it. To prove this, I'm going to change from what's called the normal view to the outline view by going to the View pull-down menu above the formatting ribbon and selecting Outline View. Switching to Outline View replaces those little thumbnails of each of the slides that appears in the left column by default in PowerPoint with essentially a text outline. Anything that appears in this outline is going to be read by a screen reader. But notice that the way this deck is designed, very little of the text is actually accessible. This designer used a lot of text boxes, and all that text is inaccessible. We're going to fix all those text box issues in a later video. For now, I'm going to return to the normal view. And here I can do one of two things in order to improve the accessibility of this slide. I can either cut out the text from this text box and paste it into the content placeholder where it says click to add text, or I can add that alt text. Again, that's for another video. In almost every case, it's easier and more efficient to place text directly into a content placeholder. So I'm going to cut and paste from the text box into the content placeholder and then I'm going to delete the text box altogether. I'll format the content placeholder by changing the background color to black and the text color to white to emulate the styling that the designer had in her original. Now I have the same design as I had previously, but when I go to check it out in the outline view, my text appears as part of the outline, so I know it's accessible to a screen reader. So, the accessibility reason we want to use layouts to place content on our slides is so that screen readers can read that information. The usability reason to use layouts is that you can use them to quickly make changes to all the slides in your deck. The Slide Master works similarly to paragraph styles if you've ever used those in your word processing documents. I'll just briefly show you what I'm talking about. Do you remember how to get to the Slide Master view? That's right. In PowerPoint, it's under View, Master, Slide Master. Now let's say I wanted all of my slides that use this title and content layout to use the Franklin Gothic Medium font instead of Calibri. I'll select both the title and the content placeholders on this layout in the master, make the change here, and close the Slide Master again. See how changing the font in the Slide Master also changed it in this slide and across all the other slides that use that same layout? Those are two strong reasons you'll want to make slide layouts your best friend from now on, and why you'll want to think twice when you're considering using manually created text boxes to contain text.